Hi, I'm Dr. Kirti Chadha, Senior Oncopathologist from Metropolis Healthcare Limited. I head the operations and the medical affairs of the Global Reference Laboratory at Metropolis as Senior Vice President. Today, I'm going to share critical information on Mammatyper, a CE-IVD-marked innovative gene expression assay for breast cancer, which does quantitative detection of CRB2, ER, PR, and Ki-67. And hence, it derives an accurate molecular subclassification of breast cancer. And this, my friends, allows the clinicians to treat based on the same Galen guidelines.
Every cancer is different. Even breast cancer cannot be considered as one single disease. There are several biological subtypes of this cancer. These subtypes differ with regard to tumor biology, prognosis, and response to treatment. Consequently, precise determination of the biological tumor subtype is one of the key elements in choosing the most suitable treatment for the individual patient.
Breast cancer, a very significant cancer affecting women across the world and India. At Metropolis, we get samples from Kashmir to Kanyakumari and from various parts of the world. And what is it that if you have to aid the clinician to decide what is the best treatment? So naturally, what is looked at is the traditional prognostic factors, the age of the patient, the size of the tumor, the nodal status. Apart from this, we have the traditional predictive factors for more than a decade now. So there is your ER, PR, HER2-new, Ki-67. And then there is a multitude of new kids on the block, the multi-gene assays. You have the Oncotype, the EndoPredict, the PAM50, the MammaPrint, and now what we present is the Mammatyper. Why is molecular subclassification important? Why should we do it? Who should we do it on? And what prognostic and predictive relevance does it have? So you know what? The patient gets the best surgery, the best chemotherapy, the best radiotherapy, the best hormonal therapy. And yet, yes, my dear friends, yet 30% of these patients recur. They have an event, an unfortunate event. And how are we going to predict that this does not happen? We need solid biomarkers. So what we use today are surrogate markers, immunohistochemistry and FISH and KISH to predict. We are just predicting the molecular subtype. But what if we can do accurate subtyping by mRNA? And that is what Mammatyper does. It isolates the RNA from the tumor tissue and does an accurate molecular subclassification. This is a typical surgical pathology unit, a CAP accredited anatomic pathology unit where the resection specimen of the breast cancer specimen will arrive. And then the growth is carried out. And how do you do this? Depending upon whether it is a primary disease or it's a post-neoadjuvant chemotherapy or a breast conservative surgery has been done or there is a mastectomy or a microdiscectomy. Whatever the type of surgery is, the grossing will be done according to that and the ideal sections will be taken. And then we have a group of experts who will look at the microscopy of the case and come up with the best diagnosis, the most accurate grading and the staging of the tumor, compounding it with the rest of the radiology and other investigations. Then immunohistochemistry is carried out. Now what immunohistochemistry needs is actually a very, very reliable, reproducible and a validated assessment. Actually, all the labs who do immunohistochemistry, especially for predictive and prognostic markers, should strictly adhere to the ASCO as well as the CAP guidelines on starting from tissue fixation to test validation and interpretation. Only and only this will yield optimal results. But is this what happens? Intra-observer variation, selection of the area that is being looked at, subjectivity in the visual estimation due to eyeballing, and different clones being used. All this creates sometimes a confusion at the prognostic and at the predictive level.
Different conditions like laboratories, operators, instruments, days, and lots have been assessed. The results show low inter and intra-site variances in quantitative biomarker results.
And this is exactly where mRNA steps in. Because ultimately, what is it that do we want? We want to treat the patient based on the St. Gallen guidelines. But the St. Gallen guidelines are based on these subtypes. Is it a luminal A tumor, B tumor, HER2 tumor, or a basal tumor? And what IHC and in situ hybridization do is give us surrogate prediction of these markers. And they are right. They are right 80% of the time, but 20% of the time they may falter. And that is when mRNA-based subclassification can give us the right answer. Because the entire subtyping and the entire prognosis depends only and only on these molecular subtypes. And hence, my friends, it is very important to get the subtype right. And this strive for excellence and for accurate molecular subclassification of breast cancer led Metropolis to do a technology transfer from BioNTech, Germany. We did extensive validation, took critical inputs from key opinion leaders, oncologists, and thereafter we did NABL and CAP quality accreditation for this gene expression assay, which utilizes RNA isolated from formalin fixed paraffin embedded breast cancer tissue. A specimen is submitted with a test requisition form, which is cross-verified for demographics. A section is cut and stained with HNE. The slide is reviewed by a surgical pathologist, and 20% minimal quantity tumor qualifies for the assay. The workflow essentially involves three steps. First, the RNA is isolated from the tissue section. Then the real-time PCR setup is put up in triplicates for each of the markers in a 96 well-plate format. This is carried out in a real-time thermal cycler. This is followed by analysis and report generation, in which the RNA expression is calculated using a relative quantification method using two reference genes, B2M, CALM, for normalization using a CE-IVD marked software. This is how a typical Mama Typer report flows. It is a three-page report, very rich in information and beautiful in its schematics. It is very easy to comprehend and to take a decision on. As you can very clearly see, just like BCR Abelson transcripts can be quantified in blood cancer, today we are being able to quantify ER, PR, CRB2 and Ki67 in breast cancer. It very clearly gives you which is the actual molecular subtype and hence very amenable to St. Gallen guidelines. Validated cutoffs are used to determine the positive or the negative status of each biomarker. Not only that, it provides quantitative results reflecting the degree of mRNA expression per biomarker. And this is what gives an accurate subtyping according to the St. Gallen guidelines. Not only that, it also can predict the chance of responding to chemotherapy, which is very important for a clinician. This has been very clearly elucidated in the FINHA study. And you can see how the patient's survival and the time to distant event is very proportionate to the Mama Typer subclassification. Last but not the least, it can predict the oncotype recurrence score. So for a particular patient, it can tell whether the tumor is going to recur or not. So it can predict the oncotype scoring. Now, when we look at this prediction of oncotype scoring, many approaches have been used in the past to predict this. And these methods were basically based on IHC or FISH. Now, we all have discussed already how Ki67 IHC shows a high intersite variability. And this used to affect the prediction of oncotype result. Now, what is the solution? Oncotype DX is based on mRNA measurements and includes these four parameters of ER, PR, HER2 and Ki. Now this again does the same thing. So it is a CE-IVD marked kit Mama Typer. It has less number of gene markers that it is assessing as compared to Oncotype. So it is not an apples to apples comparison, but it can predict the Oncotype result in that particular milieu. So I will not get into the details of the various other assays, the pros, cons, everything is freely available online and I would urge you all to compare all these assays. But as far as Indian breast cancer patient is concerned, all of these are send out tests. They have to be shipped outside the country, while Mama Typer is the only test in this particular segment which is being performed very much in our own laboratory. I'll just take you through three very relevant clinical scenarios. So there was a 62-year-old lady who presented with an infiltrating duct carcinoma, high grade, grade 3. But she had ERPR positive, a high Ki of 30 to 35, and the HER2 was equivocal. FISH was not carried out. Now this patient was referred for Mama Typer, and the results came out to be HER2 new positive. Very clearly it's come that HER2 new is positive. There is no question of equivocal, and the decision of how to treat, when to treat, what drug to add becomes very simple for the medical oncologist. In contrast to the first case, which was a luminal B-like tumor, but HER2 positive, very different from this one, which is luminal B-like, but HER2 new negative. So this 47-year-old lady was diagnosed with a grade 1 invasive duct carcinoma, and again, IHC was equivocal for HER2 new. But again, Mama Typer was able to give a confirmatory negative result and could conclusively subtype the tumor as a luminal B-like HER2 new negative tumor. The third scenario, a 40-year-old young, I would call young, still at 40 I think we are young, but he presented with a very extensive metastatic breast carcinoma. So much so that even the best of centers said that the survival was to be 3 to 6 months. And surprise, HER2 was not only equivocal by IHC, but also equivocal by FISH. Two different centers, two different results, and the best of centers, the very best of centers, but an equivocal result. But Mama Typer was able to conclusively call it a HER2 new positive. The medical oncologist took the leap of faith and put the patient on trastuzumab. And it's been 2 years now, and I'm getting goosebumps as I'm saying it because he's still alive. I would also urge you to look at these papers which show extensive clinical validation comparing Mama Typer to whether EndoPredict or to Oncotype. And as you can see, that this molecular subclassification by using mRNA is leading us to the same decision path that the other gene signature assays lead us to. This is another study which very well shows the same prediction as compared to an EndoPredict result. Thank you so much for your time. I hope this presentation was informative enough to understand. And you have understood the Mama Typer and its utility for this quantitative RNA expression of the 4 most important breast cancer genes, ER, PR, HER2 new, and Ki67. And you have been able to glean the fact that Mama Typer overcomes any inter-operator or intra-observer variability known from any other method like immunohistochemistry and FISH, which, by the way, I'm very fond of in many other areas of oncopathology. This test also provides prognostic information about a patient's risk of developing distant metastasis and the overall survival, aiding optimal patient management. We are collaborating with leading oncologists and will soon be publishing our very own patient cohort data, which will give you further insight and help catalyze the path ahead. For further information, please feel free to write to us at medconnect@metropolisindia.com.